We're back here on the Education Roundtable, and we are going to be talking with some students at San Bernardino Valley College that are in our theater arts program and our culinary arts program, and they're going to participate in the Murder Mystery Dinner Theater that we talked about a little bit earlier. So I want to introduce you to Alejandra Rubio, Eddie Jett, and Olivia Enriquez. Thank you for being with us.
You're welcome.
Alejandra, you're in the culinary arts program, and Eddie and Olivia, you're in the theater arts.
That's right. So
let's start with you. How did you choose to come to SBVC?
Well, it's close to home, and I just heard about the culinary program, so I figured I'd come here since it's close.
Okay, and did you always know you wanted to be a chef, or you wanted to study culinary arts?
No, during high school, I didn't know what to do, but watching like the Food Network and seeing the pastry chefs out there, and it inspired me to become one.
Okay. How about you, Eddie?
I've been attending Valley for 2.5 years. I'm about to transfer. I'm a theater major. I also want to focus on a minor in being an entrepreneur.
Okay.
Yeah, I like business itself. America has established that in me, capitalism and stuff like that.
Okay. What about you, Olivia?
Well, I've been coming to Valley for about 2 years, I think. So I'm in theater arts and performing arts, which includes the music program, so I do singing and acting.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. Now, all three of you are going to be involved in the Murder Mystery Dinner Theater that's coming up. Let's start with you, Alejandra. What's your role going to be during those performances?
I believe either being a server there or just working in the back of the house.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And how about you two?
Actually, my role, I'm the main guard.
Okay.
At, one of the museums. The museum is called the Hamilton Museum.
Okay.
I can't give out too much detail.
Sure,
you know?
Understood. That's what makes it a mystery, right?
But I'll tell you something. It is interesting, and it has a lot of emotion in it, and it's so sincere. And I recommend everybody around the San Bernardino area or the areas to come and watch it, and they should get more detail and insight about it.
Okay, excellent. Excellent. What's your role going to be, Olivia?
My character is an archaeologist. Her name is Elena Newman, and she is excited because this is her first archaeological expedition, and she gets to show the public her finds along with the professor, Dirk Carlton.
Okay. So each of you, several years ago, were graduating from high school, trying to decide what you wanted to do with your lives, right? Where you wanted to go to college, and you had lots of choices. Maybe one of you tell me, why did you choose Valley? Like, Alejandra, you just told us a little bit about that, but what about you guys? Like, why SBVC?
For me, I actually didn't originally choose SBVC. I went to Chaffey College. But something about it didn't really feel like it was my school. And then I decided to go to Valley. It was closer, like she said. And it really feels like family.
Okay. What do you think you have been, what have you learned the most about yourself by coming to college? What is something that you didn't know about yourself before, whether it's in the classes or friends?
I like to answer that question.
Yeah, go ahead.
It's funny. When I attended San Bernardino Valley College for the first time, I was a chemistry major.
Okay.
And I'm really good at chemistry. You know, I love chemistry. It's part of my life, too. But you see, like, in life, I feel like there should be a fulfillment to be happy, right? And should strive yourself to, like, be yourself and stuff. And I wasn't myself when I was in chemistry, you know? So I took, I auditioned for Urinetown at Valley College at the theater, at the auditorium, which is now torn down. It's going to take around like 2 years to get it built.
It's not
like
torn down.
Well,
but
it's under construction.
It's under construction. They're renovating it.
Yeah, there it just makes me feel sad. That's why I say torn down.
Right.
Yeah. And I realized that acting pushes me to become a better person. And I took that into heart. And I was like, I want to become a great person. And that's why I chose acting, because it makes me like a greater person.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anybody like to follow that answer? Because that was a pretty good answer.
He's absolutely right. Acting really, a lot of people think acting, you have to lie all the time because it's not really you. Mm. It's a character. But to really believe, to be believable, you have to feel what you're acting. It has to be a real character. You have to be very honest. I mean, I know I'm not exactly like my character, but I try to relate with her on some things that we do have in common, and it becomes really real. You become the character. I'm no longer Olivia when I'm on stage. I'm just Elena Newman.
Okay. Now, beyond culinary arts classes and theater arts classes, you're also taking English and foreign language and psychology and science. What are some of the toughest classes you've had, and have you gotten through them?
English.
English? Why English?
There's just hard and too much rules. You just have to memorize a proper way to have like MLA format and stuff like that.
Okay. Okay.
Same me, English. It's like I could write. I love poetry, but sometimes the grammar structure interferes with my success in English.
Okay. So how do you get through those? What are some of the tips that have helped you be successful in those classes?
You know, like the people, like the teachers and the instructors at Valley, they're really nice. They're really, really caring. And I love that about Valley. You see, you go to other schools, right? And they don't put the same attention and focus. Like, you know, some schools, you don't even know your professor. Mm-hmm. And at Valley College, they actually take into consideration where you're coming from, your area and stuff like that. And they help you a lot. Like, they understand your struggles. And the only thing is just push yourself. That's how I get through it. I just push myself, and they help me with their, like, smiles and just being happy and being great instructors like they've been.
That's great. That's great. What other programs on campus have you been a part of? Any other programs that you've joined in that have kind of helped you along your way to help you succeed? Can you think of any of those?
Yeah, well, I'm part of the music program.
Okay.
Which is headed by Professor Maddie Scully, and she is amazing. And just like Eddie said, the professors really care about you, and Maddie really, she's with us all day. And to follow up on your other question, yeah, my toughest class for me was Voci Soli, which is the chamber choir.
Okay.
And we have to learn a lot of really complicated, like, Renaissance kind of music. And there's different entrances, and we're like, oh, my God. You have to hear the altos, hear the sopranos. Everybody has to work together, and Maddie really, really pushes us. And at the end, it just sounds amazing because she really cares about us.
Yeah, like sometimes I sneak into the music classes just to check them sing, and they're wonderful. I love opera. Like, it's just the feeling of it, the emotion that gives me.
Right.
They're just such great singers out there, and I think like more people should come to Valley and just. Only if you have, like, a big heart, then you should come to Valley and be successful, you know?
So where do you see yourselves, let's say, 10 years from now? We'll start over here with you, Olivia. Where do you see yourself 10 years from now?
On the big screen.
The big screen. Okay. Acting, directing, producing.
Acting, and maybe even the big stage, Broadway.
Okay. Where are you, Eddie?
Hollywood.
Okay.
Hollywood and knowing many people, networking with everybody, Just being human, you know? I want to be a great actor one day, you know? I want to be in the Hollywood screen. I want my star to be on the Hollywood Boulevard.
Okay.
Yeah, that's my dream, and I'm going to push myself until I get there.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's good. How about you, Alejandra?
Probably owning my own bakery or cafe.
Okay.
As a pastry chef, that's what I dream of.
Excellent. Well, thank you to all three of you for being here with us today on the Education Roundtable. Keep pursuing your dreams. Keep working hard in your classes.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here.
Thank you, Craig.
And thanks for being here to watch Education Roundtable. We'll see you next time.